Welcome back! RPG Check here with another thrilling installment of Let's Play Mass Effect 2 Blind. We're going to finish exploring the Shrike Abyssal system. Of course, I realize I may have got some comments. I missed a planet in another system. So we're going to check out Erla Rast, and I'm going to check out that other system in whatever cluster, which I'll be able to tell from the 0%. I actually didn't even catch it. It was when writing my little notes. I like to write down all the planets and systems. And then I realized I had one planet listed twice. Oh, it's hard to explain. Anyway, I knew there were five planets. I had one planet listed twice. And I'm like, wait. That's not right. So we can only get three planets here. This one looks really cool. I like that. Bovis, or Bovis Tor, named the Shrinking Sea in an old Volus language. Bovis Tor is so named for its boiling surface, rich in glowing hot alumina, flecked with dark ridges of carbon. Its thick atmosphere of nitrogen and oxygen is no indicator of life, since the temperatures are simply too high. It is rich in stuff. I'm only getting iridium and element zero right now. That's not that much iridium. Because we have really enough platinum and palladium. Right here.
Launching probe.
Until recently, we had quite enough iridium as well, but we used that up in a bunch of upgrades, or a couple upgrades. And that's really it then. Okay. Second planet from the sun. Talus Fia. Talus Fia is a planet capable of supporting life, if that life happens to breathe ammonia. Discovered by Asari explorers, the planet was used as a bargaining chip by the Citadel Council, who quickly drafted a colonization agreement with its wealthy client race, the Volus. The Council would fund the Volus colonization effort in return for massive trade benefits. With uncharacteristic enthusiasm, an enormous Volus influx ensued, and the Council reaped the economic benefits for a dozen years before the colonization bubble burst. Today, the economic good times on Talus Fia are long gone, and modern Volus businesses are cutthroat operations. Piracy is a grave threat to shipping, as well-armed criminals see the Volus as easy prey. Colony founded in 385 CE. Population, 3,800,000,000. Capital is Ursa Deo. Or Dao. I'm surprised we're allowed to mine for resources on such a populated planet like this. You'd figure they'd have that locked down.
Probe away.
Ooh! I was just wondering when we're gonna find some element zero again. Nice.
Probe away.
Some palladium to boot. We have so much of that. Well, I'm definitely going to be looking for more. See, even this little bit is good, but it goes up.
Probe launched.
If I remember correctly, we use element zero to retrain our powers and get, like, advanced special powers and stuff like that, which is good. Because I might be changing my special power a couple more times until I find the one I really like.
Probe away.
I little bit more.
Launching probe.
Seems to be at the poles, this element zero. Any on this pole? All on the south pole. Okay, just checking for any more. Nope. Interesting. Interesting planet. And finally, does a tab. An ice giant does a tab. Sky Warden has a bluish tinge from its hydrogen methane atmosphere. Its axial tilt causes its seasons to vary wildly in temperature. Yeah, so no special stuff here, huh? I saw some iridium here for a second. There we go.
Launching probe.
Any more iridium or element zero? I don't suppose element zero, but so not a big amount. All right. Well, short but sweet. Done with the Shrike Abyssal. 100%. Back to the mass relay. And we'll see which system we didn't explore. Hold on, let me look at my notes then. I'm pretty sure it's Caleston Rift, which is where. Why does that say 100%? I've never been there. I guess because it's already explored by us, I guess. You know, it's lost in all these labels, I think. I was looking for it before and I had trouble finding it. That's where we are. Shadow Sea. What's this? Ah! 95%. Sorry guys, just gonna head and do that. Alright, so there's one planet we didn't hit. Well, it's not in this system actually, it's a Kawa system. Gotta catch them all, you know how it goes. Can't believe I forgot one like that. I hope I never have to go here again. It's very hard to find this place. There's a tiny planet, I guess. Wait. Yep. Cicada. A large Venusian hothouse, Cicada's rough weather and active magnetosphere has a reputation for confounding or destroying space probes launched to investigate it. What has been discovered is that its dense atmosphere is largely carbon dioxide and sodium, and its surface lime. Its magnetosphere suggests an iron-rich core, but its heavy gravity precludes most development. Iridium.
Probe away.
Any more iridium? Yes. Indeed.
Launching probe.
More.
Launching probe. Away.
One more.
Probe launched.
Done. Good enough for me. Okay, well, I think now I'm gonna head for the local cluster. Finally, and check
fuel remains.
Check it out. We're there, dude. Fuel. Here we go. I always like looking at our actual solar system here. Cool. Pluto is not a planet. Check it out. Pluto is one of Sol's numerous ice dwarf worlds. It is mainly of note for being the gravitational anchor for the mass relay to Arcturus. Pluto and the Charon Relay, formerly encased in ice and considered a moon. Cool. You kidding me? So, the Charon moon was actually a mass relay encased in ice. Oh my god. That's, like, staggering. To think things like that, you know, might actually be true. You never know. Some of these things that they consider moons might actually be ancient machines of some kind covered in ice, perhaps rock, attracted to it. That's amazing. Okay, yeah, so Pluto and the Charon Relay orbit each other. Pluto's orbit was circularized in 2157 as a side effect of the Charon mass relay recovery operations. Population for gateway stations 9300. I'm gonna guess this information is scientifically accurate to our actual Pluto and the other worlds. Moderate. Well, look, we should find an iridium here on Pluto.
Probe launched.
I guess no one, like, as far as this mining goes, no one even got around to mining, or we just have better equipment than anyone else, so we are able to mine things like
probe away
deeper into the crust than other people are. That's why this stuff is still here to be found. Because obviously, as far as Pluto, I mean, people have been here. We've been way beyond this solar system in this story. It's actually high enough for me to justify.
Launching probe.
Once we get to 100K, I'm gonna stop looking for iridium as it is.
Probe launched.
And it looks like we're gonna get there relatively soon.
Probe away.
A lot of iridium on Pluto. Definitely. All right. Neptune. So Neptune, like Uranus, Uranus, which is not much better, has plentiful helium. Its remoteness made it an unpromising target for mining before the development of the Mass Effect drive. With Uranus cheaper to exploit, it has never seen extensive development. The only permanent human presence is a small research facility on Triton. Population on Triton is 70. Results poor. Well, there's not much for poor Triton to uncover here.
Launching probe.
Some more iridium. Look at that marking. It has platinum on it. Alright, we're good. And Uranus. After the development of Mass Effect FTL Drive, distant Uranus was the target of a land rush to exploit its combination of plentiful helium-3 fuel and shallow, for a gas giant, gravity well. Today, Uranus is the largest producer of helium-3 in Alliance space. Population is 371,000 at the Sakharov station. Depleted. Well, there's some. You can still find a little bit. I don't see it as worth the expense of using probes. Definitely not. Yep, they've mined it thoroughly. Where's the next planet? Saturn! Saturn has been a major source of helium-3 fuel for fusion plants since the 2150s. The moon of Titan is mined for hydrocarbons and used as a hostile environment training facility for Alliance Marines. Populations on orbitals in Titan, 117,000. Capital is the Huygens Dome? I don't know how to pronounce that. Scan results are good. Some iridium here.
Launching probe.
And we're good with that. We're looking to see if we have any element zero here. Apparently not. Okay, so that's the fourth, outermost fourth orbit. If I miss a planet here, it won't be Latal, because it already says 100%. So I got that, that, and that. So we need this. Jupiter. Jupiter's deep gravity well and lethal radiation have kept its moons from being significantly exploited. The largest outpost is Binary Helix Corporation's Nautilus facility, attached to the underside of Europa's ice sheet. Population on all the moons is 9,100. Moderate results. It would make sense that all the planets out here have been depleted of element zero, if they ever had it. Nope, not launching a probe game. What is this, fourth planet? Fourth planet from the sun. Mars. Once considered a prospect for terraforming and colonization, the discovery of faster than light travel turned Mars into a quiet backwater. Its southern pole is a historical preserve centered on the Prothean ruins found there. Immigration and development are restricted as the search for Prothean artifacts continues. Well, we can't have a mine here. Yeah, restricted, right? Is that what it said? Development? Immigration and development? Alright, can't mine it. I'm gonna go to Earth last. Let's skip to Mercury. A handful of solar power stations exist on peaks of eternal light at the north and south poles of Mercury. The difficulties imposed by the planet's proximity to the sun and high orbital velocity have limited development. Population 340. Moderate results. Just looking for Ezo. Surprisingly, not finding any. I can't even see this. Venus? Where is it? It's hidden under the marker or something? Oh no. Never mind. That's Venus. With its molten temperatures, sulfuric acid clouds, and crushing carbon dioxide atmosphere, Venus has only a handful of aerostat research outposts. Population 800. There are some resources here, but I do not need them. What the hell? Let's take some platinum.
Probe away. Probe launched.
What the hell? Earth! For detailed information, please refer to the Standard Issue Alliance Galactic Codex. Earth's orbit is riddled with debris generated by bootstrap space development. Use of kinetic barriers is recommended at altitudes over 85 kilometers. Population on the surface is 11.4 billion. Population for the L4 and L5 stations is 250,000. Thank you. We can't see the moon here. Asteroid belt. I remember somebody telling me for looking for something here. On one of the planets. I don't know if I just mined some random thing.
Launching probe.
I don't remember who said it. It was so long ago. Or which planet it is. I've mined this one. Can't mine Mars.
Launching probe.
No results here. Just trying random stuff. Here.
Really, Commander?
Really, Commander?
Probing Uranus.
Maybe this is what they say. Okay, I want to see what else it says. I don't know if this is what that person was alluding to, but...
Launching probe.
Anything else funny to say?
Probe launched.
Nope. So yeah, maybe this is what they were, that person was talking about. I've already scanned Neptune. And I've definitely scanned Pluto. Alright, cool. So, next episode, we're going to actually take on another quest. Anything, Kelly?
No messages for you, Commander.
Thank you. We're going to check out another... We're going to do another loyalty quest next episode, so... Stay tuned for that. I haven't decided who... Thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. And enduring, grow strong.